The Enhanced Recovery Programme is composed of a number of factors designed to help speed up your recovery after your operation. This class is the first stage of the process in encouraging you to be an active participant in your own care and recovery from your joint replacement. By explaining the journey you are all about to embark on, we aim to better prepare you for your operation and post-operative recovery, and to help you understand what as a healthcare team we are trying to achieve. We hope you will have a better understanding of the goals we are all aiming for you to achieve, so that you are able to return home sooner than would otherwise have been expected.
In a healthy hip joint, the surface of the ball and socket are covered in a smooth, slippery material called articular cartilage, enabling smooth, pain-free movement. In an arthritic joint, this cartilage becomes worn, exposing the bone underneath and making the joint surfaces roughened and deformed. This makes movement and walking painful. Often the joint will stiffen and the thigh muscles can become weak. The pain can become severe enough to disrupt sleep and significantly reduce overall quality of life. A hip replacement involves removal of the worn-out hip joint, replacing it with an artificial joint. A variety of different bearings are used depending on your age, level activity, and the size and shape of your hip joint. Here, for example, we have a metal ball with a polyethylene socket, and here we see a ceramic head with a ceramic socket. Your new hip joint will either be cemented in place or secured with a tight press fit, otherwise known as uncemented. Both methods provide secure fixation, allowing you to fully weight bear immediately post-operation. You will have a scar on the side of your hip, which will be covered with a dressing for the first few days. To reassure you, hip replacement surgery is in general extremely successful, with high levels of satisfaction and low complication rates.
You will be asked to attend a preoperative assessment appointment approximately 2 weeks before your operation to assess your general health, well-being and fitness for surgery. Routine blood tests, an ECG, heart tracing and a urine sample will be taken. You will be seen by the surgical team and the risks and benefits of the operation will be explained and you'll be asked to sign a consent form. If you take any medication, please bring your prescription with you to this appointment. We also need to know if you are likely to need help when you leave hospital, if you already receive support from social services, a district nurse visits, or you are struggling with daily activities. This enables us to make the necessary arrangements to support you on discharge. You'll be given 2 cartons of a carbohydrate drink, which is designed to minimise the effect of starving you before your operation. Please take 1 the night before your operation and the 2nd drink before 6 a.m. on the day of your operation. You should have a shower at home before you come into hospital. An occupational therapist will see you at your preoperative assessment. The OT's role is to see how you will manage at home after your operation. They will gather information on your home environment and what equipment you may have in place already. They will also look at your furniture heights to assess if they are suitable for you after your operation and organise any necessary equipment. The OT will collect your completed home information sheet at the end of this presentation. The OT will discuss the precautions you will need to follow post-operatively to protect your new joint whilst it is healing. Due to the nature of the operation, some of your muscles around your new hip will be weaker and the ligaments will have been temporarily stretched. As a result of this, there are 4 movements that you should avoid to limit the chances of your hip dislocating. The 4 precautions to follow are: no crossing the legs, do not lie on your unoperated side in bed, no twisting at the hip, do not bend beyond a right angle. These should apply until your outpatient's appointment. As you will not be able to reach your feet, you may need to obtain dressing aids to help with this. These will be demonstrated at the end of the presentation. It would be helpful to plan for your discharge by doing things like organising your kitchen so that frequently used items are to hand. Ensure rooms will be easily accessible whilst using a walking aid by taking up loose rugs and moving bulky furniture. Ensure you have support for shopping or have stocked up your freezer and cupboards prior to coming in. On the day of your operation, you will be admitted to the ward by the nursing staff and prepared to go to theatre. Nursing staff will record your observations, a doctor will draw an arrow on the limb you are having operated on, and your consent form will be checked. A theatre gown and paper pants will be given for you to wear. You will be able to speak to an anaesthetist before the operation if you have any concerns about the anaesthetic. You will be given further painkillers designed to be working in your system for pain control after your operation. The operating theatres either run for a half day or a full day. If your operation is planned for an afternoon list, you will be encouraged to have a light breakfast before 7 a.m. so that you are not starved all day. A porter will escort you to theatre reception on a trolley about 20 minutes before your operation, where you will wait before being taken into the anaesthetic room.
In the anaesthetic room, you'll be attached to some routine monitors by the theatre staff, and a drip will be placed in the back of your hand by the anaesthetist. You'll be sat upright to allow a spinal anaesthetic to be injected into your lower back. This will numb your legs for the duration of the operation and for a short time after. We will then lie you down and you'll be given an injection to make you feel sedated or asleep.
After your operation, you are moved to the recovery room, where the recovery nurses continue to check your observations. The anaesthetic wears off quite quickly once you are in recovery. You may need extra painkillers or treatment for feeling sick whilst in there, and once fully recovered, a ward nurse will collect you and escort you back to the ward. Once on the ward, your observations will be taken regularly and the sensation, circulation and movement to your feet will be checked. You will have a pair of boots on your feet which will pulsate every 30 seconds and possibly elastic stockings. These reduce the risk of developing a deep vein thrombosis. The boots are removed once you are walking, however the stockings should be worn for 6 weeks post-operatively. You will be given a second pair on discharge, so you have one to wear and one to launder. You will need assistance to get these on and off at home, so please have a think about friends or relatives that can assist you with them. If you don't have anyone to support you with this on discharge, please let us know. The nurse will monitor your pain and nausea and vomiting score and give you pain relief and anti-sickness medication as required. You will be given pain relief regularly. If you need further pain relief, let the nurses know. Pain from hip surgery generally is fairly easy to control with regular pain relieving tablets. The nurses will encourage you to eat and drink as soon as possible, and drips will be taken down when your blood pressure is stable. After surgery, it is advisable to drink a mixture of drinks, tea, coffee and juices, rather than just water. Drinking too much water at this stage can affect your recovery. Urinary catheters are avoided if possible after surgery, and you will be encouraged to mobilise onto a commode. This is a good way of starting early movement in your new joint, helping to reduce stiffness and swelling. Some patients with mainly heart or kidney problems may need production of their urine closely monitored, and you will have a catheter placed during your anaesthetic. If you have difficulty in passing urine after your operation, a catheter may also be placed on the ward. The numbness in your legs will be short acting. This will allow you to mobilise within 4 to 6 hours of returning to the ward. Providing that you feel well and your blood pressure is stable, a physiotherapist or a member of the nursing team will assist you out of bed to stand up and take a few steps and sit back down on your bed. If you feel okay, you can sit out in your chair or take a short walk. You will be given a Zimmer frame at this point, but as soon as you're able, we will progress you onto elbow crutches. Early movement of the new joint is important in reducing stiffness and swelling, which in turn will improve your long-term recovery. We also know early mobilisation reduces the risk of deep vein thrombosis, chest infections and pressure sores. A physiotherapist or a physiotherapy assistant will see you daily to encourage you with your exercises and independence with mobility. It is vital that you take your painkillers regularly in order to perform your exercises and mobilise successfully. Whilst on the ward, you will be offered regular pain relief. However, if you experience pain which is not relieved by these, please tell one of the nursing staff. Ideally, we'd like you to do 5 to 10 repetitions of each exercise 3 to 5 times a day, increasing the number of repetitions as you are able. Generally, frequent short bursts of exercises are best. It is important to find a happy balance. Performing too many exercises may aggravate swelling and pain. Performing too few will cause stiffness and loss of movement. All the leg exercises will minimise the risk of blood clot formation, strengthen the muscles, regain hip joint flexibility, and improve your walking. A member of the physiotherapy team will check your progress whilst you're in hospital. Regaining strength and movement is hard work and takes determination and dedication, so it is really important to keep yourself motivated and do your exercises to get the best outcome. Before going home, the therapist will ensure you can manage steps or stairs, as well as independently getting in and out of your bed and chair. It is normal to experience swelling in your operated leg. Therefore, it is important to keep your feet and ankles moving. Having a rest on the bed for an hour in the afternoon is also a good way to drain the swelling from the leg. On occasions, you may hear clicking or clunking sounds from your new hip. Unless it causes significant pain or feelings of instability in your hip, it is nothing to worry about. A sensation of the hip stiffening up can also occur if you have been sitting or standing in one position for too long. It is important to change position regularly and keep active to prevent this from happening. Following discharge home, we advise that you continue exercises that are provided in your booklet and will be demonstrated at the end of the DVD. Muscular ache is normal and expected after exercising, but this should decrease over time. Outpatient physiotherapy is not normally required following this surgery, as long as you are walking regularly and doing your exercises. When you feel comfortable, you can start to use only one crutch or a walking stick if you prefer for short distances, and gradually build up to walking unaided over a 6-week period. Occupational therapists will also see you on the ward after your operation to ensure you can do everything that you need to do in order to manage at home. Discharge arrangements are commenced early on in your care, and this will be discussed with you. We aim to get you as independent and as mobile as possible before you leave hospital so that you feel confident to manage your own care. Your discharge home is led by the nurses on the ward, working closely with the physiotherapist and occupational therapist. Your estimated date of discharge will be 2 to 3 days after your operation. This gives you and your relatives a date to aim for so that preparations can be made. This date is an estimate. Some of our patients go home sooner than this, and some patients need a little bit longer. A letter will be sent to your GP to inform him or her of your discharge, and the nurse will make arrangements for the care of your wound. Your stitches are dissolvable and you'll be given a supply of pain relief. A side effect of the pain relieving tablets is constipation. To prevent this, you'll be given some laxatives to take home. Eating fresh fruit and vegetables and drinking water will also help. You'll be given an outpatient appointment to see your consultant or team at 6 weeks post-operatively. You'll be given the contact numbers for the ward if you have any concerns once at home. You should be able to go home by car. Please arrange for a relative or friend to take you home. Ambulances are not usually required. When you get home, it is very important to continue to take your pain relief regularly to allow you to do your exercises and daily activities. It is important to gradually increase the number of exercises you are doing throughout the day, but please make sure you pace your activities. Don't do all your jobs at once. We advise that you do exercises at least 3 times a day. It is better to do short but frequent bursts of exercises. Swelling is to be expected and can be managed by resting your leg on the bed in the afternoon and regular walking. Continue to progress your exercises, walking, and build up your activities gradually. Remember, you have had a major operation, you're likely to feel tired, and it may take you several weeks to fully recuperate. You will be contacted by telephone within 5 to 7 days of discharge by the Enhanced Recovery Sister or one of the nursing team to check on your progress and offer support and reassurance. In the longer term, the benefits of having a total hip replacement are less pain, a functional range of movement, a better walking pattern, improved ability to carry out daily activities, being able to return to work if appropriate for you, and to return to those leisure and social activities you've not been able to do because of your arthritis. We hope this DVD has been informative and wish you well for your operation.